Let's go. Ronnie, how are you? I can't tell you guys how excited I've been for this night all day. Tonight is a seriously special show for me because this is the last headline show I do in America before I go and write my second album. And I know I shouldn't say this, but I've had some of the best gigs of my entire life in America, and you guys mean so much to me. So you guys, ready to make this a magical one tonight? Are you guys gonna sing every single word with me tonight? Are you gonna sing every single word even if you do not know the words? That's what I wanna hear. I'm gonna be singing some songs from my only album, In the Lonely Hour. And this next one is one of my personal favorites. And I hope you know it, it's called Leave Your Lover. I don't have much to give, but I don't have it all. What use is money when you need someone to hold? Don't want a direction, I'm just falling down this road, waiting for you to bring me from out the cold. You'll never know the endless nights, the rhyming of the rain, or how it feels to fall behind in what you call his name.
Baby, you're my love.
Traveling around the world now, touring for nearly 3 years in total, and I've gone from rooms of 100 people to playing rooms this size, and it has been the most incredible experience of my life. And the most magical thing about my job, the thing that I wake up and look forward to when I'm doing shows, number one is seeing you guys, but the second most magical thing about my job is getting the opportunity to meet you all face to face and explain to you a little bit about what these songs are about and where they've come from. Because this album, I know, is a little bit sad sometimes, but this record was a huge, huge breakthrough in my life. Before I made this album, I was making the shittest music have ever heard in your life. It was generally awful. And I had no idea how to get my feelings that were inside on paper and on CD. And what this album marks for me is the first time I was ever myself in my music. Which can be a really, really hard thing to do sometimes. And the way that I did that was by being as honest as I possibly could. Every single song on this album is a personal story and memory of mine. And some of these stories, I couldn't even tell my mum and dad at the time because they were so personal. And now that I can tell you guys, it feels so good. And I promise I will never stop doing that. And this next song is actually one of the first truly honest songs I wrote. And the story behind this one is the night before I wrote this song, I went out in London and I got very, very drunk. Very drunk. And I basically rang someone that I really fancied at the time and I told them everything in my drunken state. And I woke up the next morning and I was so embarrassed. And the only thing for me to do to get over that was to write a song. So I wrote this next one, and I hope you guys like it. This is called I've Told You Now.
Talking it, you know me well. I know. Yeah. Let me see your hand, Charlie. I want to see every single person on your feet, clap with your hands. Repeat after me. He'll never love you like I can, can. He could be a sinner, a rich gentleman. He could be a preacher, when you're solid up. And he could be a liar, or a witness man. But he'll never love you like I can, can. He could be a stranger, give a second glance. He could be a trophy. I Let me see your hands, Charlie. very simple. And if you can't get it, just ask for that. Here we go. Side to side. Side to side, guys. Yeah. Two steps. Thank you, God. Does anybody in the room tonight know a girl called Amy Winehouse? This is for you, Amy.
But I can never be with you, as long as that we know, and this regret I got accustomed to. That's what we want when we were at our prime. I know I had a man on that, cause every moment we get snagged. I don't know why I got so attached. It's my responsibility, you do not owe nothing to me, but to walk away, I'll have your capacity.
Baby, everyone say a big hello to Jeff and Mark behind me. I'd like to slow things down a little bit now, and this is where I'd like to chat a little bit about the core of this album, and what inspired this album, and the reason, the person who inspired this record was a guy that I fell in love with 3 years ago, and my heart was completely broken, and it was perfect timing, I guess, because at the same time, I got a record deal, and went to make this album, and all I knew was I wanted to make an album of love songs, and I was finding that hard because I don't think I've ever been in love before with someone who's truly loved me back. So I decided I'm in love with you guys and you love me back. That's different. That's a different situation. But I decided to make an album, the album that I didn't have as a kid. An album for anyone who is lonely and anyone who doesn't feel love back. Because I feel exactly the same as you do. And this next song, for me, is sometimes hard for me to sing now because I'm over the person who the record's about, which is a good thing. It's a very good thing. But it just means that songs like this one I'm about to sing are no longer my songs. They are your songs now. And I truly hope that they can help you as much as they helped me. But I also hope that you're not going through what I went through, because it's fucking horrible. But if you are, right now, tonight, this is for you.
Thank you.
I begin. No words can explain the way I'm missing you tonight. Just emptiness, this hole that I'm inside. These tears, they tell their own story. Told me how to cry when you were gone. But the feelings overwhelm me. It's much too strong. Can I lay by your side next to you? Now don't want to be here if I can't be with you tonight. I'm reaching out to you. Can you hear my call?
Thank you so much. Right, guys. Now, it's your turn to help me sing a song. Will you help me sing this next one? Who knows this song? That's good. That's very good. But I know that you can be a little bit louder than that. I said, Ronnie, who knows this song? That's very good. Very, very good. But one more time for me. Even if you don't actually know the song, pretend you do. It's very easy. One more time. Who knows this song? Is actually the only song on my album which isn't about love. When I was writing this record, I got put into some of the most amazing writing sessions, and I met some songwriters which taught me so much and continue to teach me so much. But there was one songwriter I got put in the studio with who wasn't actually a songwriter. He pretended to write music, and his only reason to make music was to make money. And for me, music is a much deeper thing than that to me. I make music so I can stand on stages like this and sing for you guys every night. And this person upset me so much that to cut a long story short, I wrote this next song about them. So if you know this rally, please sing this as loud as you can.
Heaven's not a sin, don't you fret it. Oh, I have no money on my mind. No money on my mind, no money on my mind. No, I have no money on my mind. Heaven's not a sin, don't you fret it. No, I have no money on my mind.
for my incredible band, the Back of Zero. I hope you had a good time tonight!
And it is happened to me right in front of my face. My feelings can't describe it.
Thank you so much. I just want to say something. As this is my last show in America before I run my second album, I just want to say, I'm going to address you right now as if I'm addressing the whole of America, okay? But I just want to say to you all, I am so overwhelmed to be playing rooms this big. Thank you so much. I come from a tiny village in the middle of England, where there's no one there. And when I was releasing this record and when I was making this album, I could never have imagined to be standing on stages like this every single night. So thank you for buying my album. Thank you for coming to my show. And I promise I'm gonna go away and try and top it with a second one. But when I was writing this record, I decided that I didn't want to end the album on a sad note. So I got in the studio with Jimmy Napes and Hal from Disclosure, and the title of this next song in my head. And I wanted this song to be that link, that lead on to my second record. And I wanted it to be overall a love letter to my soulmate, whoever that person may be, wherever that person may be. And this is called Make It To Me.
Since it's
Thank you so much for coming. Please get home safely.